Listen, at the end of the day, nothing prepares you for that moment when you're staring at a man, a woman, or a child through a 12-power scope on top of a high-powered rifle. And you have to make that choice. You know, in sniper school in the Marine Corps, they aren't screening people out for whether or not you can shoot or whether or not you know the art of concealment and camouflage. Of course, you'll fail for those things. What they're screening for is maturity. What they're screening for is good judgment. Are you going to make the right decision at that critical moment when the battlefield is utter chaos and you have someone's life in your hands? Are you going to make the right choice?
You don't know whether you're shooting someone that has a bomb and might kill your colleagues, or whether this is an innocent that's been put there.
War is so rarely ever black and white. And that, I think, is what contributes to this moral injury that Jason speaks of. It's not about losing something. It's not about losing part of yourself overseas so much as this burden that you bring home. You got to carry that burden with you for the rest of your life. You're right. And, you know, sometimes you're strong enough to carry it. Sometimes you need the help and support of others to carry it. But at the end of the day, I think of it more as a burden. I'm carrying this burden on my conscience. I'm carrying it upon my soul, upon my religious beliefs, upon my family.
So it didn't challenge your beliefs, but did it change your beliefs?
Oh, it certainly challenged them. You know, I grew up in a Lutheran household, great parents, all of those things. I believed in evil, right? But the first time you see evil, true evil in the world, and you look at it and you see it happening, you know, we experienced moments like Open, the movie in American Sniper, where he's got to shoot the child. You know, we were in a battle once, and the senior Taliban commander was using young children to run intelligence reports across the battlefield, not armed, not carrying weapons, but nonetheless moving from the front line back to the rear. And there was, at one point in time, a young girl picked up an RPG that had been dropped by a Taliban fighter. And we had to make the decision about whether to shoot. Now, the man on the gun opted not to. It was his decision alone. Nobody was going to order him to do that. Nonetheless, not pulling the trigger is a burden that he was maybe going to have to bear for the rest of his life, because if that RPG had been used to kill a Marine, that's something that he would have had to regret or doubt or second guess until the day he died. Now, fortunately, it didn't turn out that way. We didn't have to, you know, kill an innocent young girl, and no Marines were killed or hurt. Those are the types of situations that are happening on the battlefield, and it's impossible.